So if there's one piece of advice that I could give you with all of this, because this is just my list. This is what I've decided to not spend money on. Yours is going to be very different. But if there's one piece of advice that I could give you, it really is, when I retired at 52 and my husband at 53, there were some lifestyle changes we had to make in order to afford it. We had made the choice very early on that we were willing to forgo some things and reevaluate our lifestyle in exchange for years of not having to work. One of the things that we do is not spending money on all of the things we used to spend money on. And so I have a list of things here that I don't spend money on anymore. And at the end, I'll tell you about a couple that I do spend, that I do still spend money on. So the first thing that we don't spend money on anymore is dry cleaning. Part of that is necessity. We're not having to go to work every day and we don't have, you know, an office to go to or really anybody to impress. So we don't have any dry cleaning anymore. We have clothes that say they're supposed to be dry cleaned, but we wear those very infrequently. And also we just don't do it. We hand wash things. The second thing that we don't spend nearly as much money on as we used to is going out to eat. We used to go out several times a week, 3-4 times a week, even sometimes. And we did that because we enjoy doing it. But now we have just decided that it's so expensive and it's just such an easy way to save money that we're just a little bit pickier about how often we go and where we go. And honestly, we've gotten really used to it. So it's not a big deal anymore. The third thing that I don't spend nearly as much money on as I used to are books. I love holding a book in my hand. And so I used to buy physical copies of books all the time. But now I do that sometimes still because, you know, I just do. But most of the time, I would say 90% of the books that I read or that my husband reads comes from the library, either as an ebook on Kindle or just a, you know, physical copy from the library. We also shop thrift stores. I shop a couple of online stores. Book Outlet and Pango are great resources to buy used and or much cheaper books. And I've just changed my habit. It's been a hard one. I'm an avid reader. I've read up to 60 books a year. My husband reads sometimes close to that as well, sometimes more, but we've just decided that's not where we want to spend our money. The fourth thing that I don't spend money on anymore are individual water bottles, you know, the plastic water bottles. Now that change came primarily from the time that we spent in Mexico. Mexico changed us a lot. And I did a whole video on what I learned from living in Mexico and how it changed me. I'll put a link to it in the description and right here. But in Mexico, the place that we lived was so hot. It was a tropical jungle basically, that we had to carry a water bottle around us wherever we went. You just couldn't survive without having water with you at all times. And so we just got our reusable water bottles and we filled them up with the filtered water that we had, but we didn't buy the individual water bottles at restaurants or anywhere that we went. And after almost 3 years of that, we just got really used to not doing that anymore. And so now we just use our water bottles. And I know this is something that a lot of people have started doing as water bottles have gotten cool, but that can be a big expense. And we just don't do it anymore. Not to mention that it's way better for the environment. I'm not going to get on my soapbox, but it is. The next thing, and this was a big one for me, and it came mostly with a change in lifestyle, is getting coffee outside of the house. I used to be a 5 to 6 day a week Starbucks girl, but not anymore. It's just too expensive and it just feels like a waste. We have more time than anything right now, so we can very easily just make our own coffee. It's really hard to justify spending that much money on a coffee other than for a treat. I would rather not have to work to support my coffee shop habit. The next thing that I don't spend money on the way I used to are clothes. Now, again, because I'm retired and I'm not going into the office, I don't have to worry about, you know, dressing for office attire. My needs are much more simple now than they ever were. I have sort of basic casual clothes and the occasional going out, dressing up clothes, and that's about it. So I'm able to pare down my wardrobe to begin with, but also when I need something, or even if I just want something, I have the time to shop sales. I have the time to go to the thrift store to see what's available there first. I do buy new clothes occasionally, but it's rare. It's only when I really need something, I need to replace something or whatever. I just don't clothes shop that much anymore. I love fun clothes, don't get me wrong. But once we really sort of decluttered and got rid of most of our belongings when we retired and moved to Mexico, we really just haven't wanted to go back to that huge closet full of things again. So it's just one of the choices that we make, just to not spend money there. The next thing I've been able to really reduce is gas. Yes, I'm a 12-year-old little boy. I still laugh at jokes like that. Anyway, I don't spend that much money on gas. I'm not driving all over the place. I'm not commuting. Neither is my husband. So I think I fill my tank up maybe once every 3 weeks-ish, unless I go on a road trip somewhere or a day trip or something, which is very infrequently, but I just don't spend that much money on gas anymore. When I do, again, I'm able to be, you know, very thoughtful about it. I only buy gas from the grocery store gas station where I've accumulated points, where I get a discount, that kind of stuff. And my gas bill is nothing compared to what it used to be. And the last thing that I don't spend much money on anymore, this is maybe once or twice a year now, where it used to be a lot more frequent, are mani-pedis. I know, I just gave it up. Again, the time we spent in Mexico really broke me of that habit. You can't even have a pedicure there that lasts more than a couple days. If you're walking around in the sand, it just gets destroyed. There was no reason to have it. I just don't. I just got out of the habit. Again, I use it though as a treat. I'm not trying to make myself suffer here at all. I save for treats. A coffee out, that's a treat. A mani-pedi, that's a big, big treat. The physical copy of a book to keep on my bookshelf. It's a treat. You can see a pattern here. There are things that I have definitely deprioritized, but also things that I have just decided to put in the treat bucket versus the everyday bucket. It's just a little lifestyle tweak. It's not that big of a deal. Now, there are also some things that I do still spend money on. And one in particular that is an addition, something that I never used to spend money on, but I do now. That one thing is bird food. I know. I joined the group. I'm the bird, crazy bird lady with the bird feeder. And I go, ooh, every time I see birds at my feeder. I just do. So I have to buy bird food. That's an additional. We had a hard time figuring out whether to put that in the food category or the entertainment category of our budget. I'm only half kidding. It's both. But we do buy bird food. And the other thing that I do still spend money on is my hair. That's a whole thing. I didn't want to, at this point in my life, be still, you know, dyeing my hair and getting cuts like this take every 6 weeks or so. But, you know, that was something, cancer played a part of that. Because I didn't have hair for quite a while and it took a long time to grow back. And when it did grow back, I realized that my hair was about 50-50 gray and brown. I was kind of hoping it was all gray because I was wanting to just go with it. And I love gray hair and I can't wait to have a full head of gray hair. I just don't have it yet. It's about 50-50. And I just decided I didn't like it. So I'm still spending money on my hair. It's like the one thing that I still do. I've decided that's the thing for me, right? Like I've just decided that's the thing. I don't wear a lot of makeup. I don't spend a lot of money on skincare products. I don't do the mani-pedis. There's a lot of the grooming things that I just don't do. And so I'm allowing myself this. this is what I'm doing. And I'll stop doing it as soon as I can. But for now, this is what I'm doing. And as I look back on this list, now that I'm saying it all out loud, I realize how much of the list was really just habit. How much of these things I spent money on just out of habit. And I really do wish I had reevaluated that sooner. I don't know if that would have helped me retire sooner or not, but I really wish I had. These were all lifestyle things. So if there's one piece of advice that I could give you with all of this, because this is just my list, this is what I've decided to not spend money on. Yours is going to be very different. But if there's one piece of advice that I could give you, it really is to think about the things you spend money on and how much of them are born out of habit versus out of real desire or real need. And breaking the habits associated with a lot of the items on my list is really just about a change process. And sometimes when you're going through big change, making these small changes seems more difficult. Sometimes it's like ripping the Band-Aid. So if you're interested in overcoming the fear of change or getting away from the feeling that change is too daunting, check out this video for some tips and strategies.